them.
You're sort of giving it more of a wiggle. A whisk is more like that.
I'm off to cookery school, where chef Gizzi Erskine wants to show me how technology made food preparation so much easier.
Is that any good?
Afraid not. Okay, so the whole point in whisking is that you actually need to aerate your products, all right? Okay. So you need to actually beat air into it. So you can see how I'm lifting the egg up there.
Yes. Getting air into it.
But why am I doing this? It's your job.
I was enjoying watching you do that. Okay.
You carry on. I'm going to get on with showing you my methods.
Okay.
Right, now, one of these guys. Makes a bit of a difference.
The mixer Gizzy's using may be from a later decade, but the engineering inside is pure 50s.
Okay, and it's just simply a matter of turning it on.
Wood paid close attention to the science of how women went about making their breads and cakes.
How are you doing there? I'm going to have to say this back. Okay, it's you against the meringue. You need to put some more gusto into this.
But you are. You've got two different processes going on. You're going round and round, lifting it, but also working your way around the bowl.
Yeah.
It's not just a circular action.
Which you can kind of see is what the Kenwood mixer does, you know.
Yeah, too. Yeah, circular and circles within circles.
Yeah, exactly.
See, as an engineer, I look at your repetitive motion, circles and circles, and if that electric mixer didn't exist, I'd invent it.
I think it's just about there. I can also say, without doubt, we have a much glossier finish.
Well, compared to that.
Definitely more solid, but there's the ultimate test to see whether your meringue is good or not.
Which is?
Well, I'm going to pop this on top of your head.
Go on, then.
I think that's doing pretty all right. And you can see that what we've got here, we've managed to do, well, I'd say under 5 minutes.
So how much time do you think all this must have saved a housewife?
I mean, if you think about it, this meringue would have taken about 15 minutes. Making bread, which I imagine was a daily occurrence in those days, easily 15 minutes with the kneading and mixing. So there's half an hour straight away.
And it's not just about saving time, it's also the energy expended, because that is physically hard work doing that. So it's a massive workout in the kitchen.